And that's why we need to have leaders who would know how to enforce the law. And enforcing the law would require adhering to the rule of law. There are exceptions. Kailangan marunong tayong manindigan at tumayo sa pagtatanggol nito. Sa ating panahon, dumaan ang maraming magham. Joey again mentioned something. Not too long ago, there was a very big crisis in the country when an impeachment proceeding was going on in the Senate. And the case is already filed. And all of a sudden, the judges walk out. The judges walk out, and they went to Edgenstein. And of course, called for people to come. At that instance, when that was happening, it was so easy to just join the mob and be one of the popular causes. And as mayor of Manila, I thought, and I decided, this is not right. This will only open the floodgates of instability in the country. You cannot be removing presidents by street action and another people's power. And with that decision, I stood back and I stayed on and rallied our people in the city to be ready to defend the Constitution. I had friends in the Catholic Church who talked to me, pleaded with me to join. But one of them is here, Senior David, I will. He convinced me, he tried to convince me. After 3 hours talking to each other, I convinced him to defend the rule of law. Even my closest friends and my political allies, again, some of them are here. Secretary Heavy Season came in late, and my former city illegal officer, for criminal assault, I will do sa akin, punta na tayo ron. Baka tayo may iwanan. Sabi ko sa kanila, kung maiiwanan tayo sa tamang desisyon, maiiwanan. But I will not join. It's a truth. And I will continue to defend the President, Maracanan, and the Constitution. And we should be ready to do just that. Even my own sister, who was in the States, called me by long distance. And she said, anong ginagawa mo dyan? Nakita ka namin sa television. Nasa Malacanang ka pa. Umalis ka na dyan. Ang political career mo, mawawala. And I told my sister, my elder sister, ang itinuro sa atin, ang ating ama, ay manindigan para sa batas. I'm just following the lessons given us by our father. And that motivated me to stand back at that position. And I stood by the side of the president up to the last day that he was in office. Of course, when the Supreme Court decided later on, Justice Congress here, recognizing the president, administration, and giving it its own legality, we in public office do not work with the new administration. That should also answer many of your questions. Why are you working with the president in this case? Eh, ito na ang nahalal, ito na ang bumilala, ito na ang administration, ito na ang pangulo. Si Pangulong Arroyo ang pangulo ng bansa. Kaya, igalang at tulungan. And in the same manner, I'd like to also narrate in the continuing threat that she experienced, there are at least 4 major attempts at overthrowing it. Some of them are military plans and plots. As mayor of Manila again, I stood back and consistently followed the rule of law. You cannot dispose of a president simply because, according to you, and according to your intentions, this is the good thing that can happen to the country. So every time that the presidency, the president was threatened, I again defended the rule of law. Simply because we know that without all of us following the rule of law, all of this natural wealth, all of these natural qualities of our people will not give us anything better than what we are having today.